news and latest headlines. Public media festivities in Brussels have been cancelled after the arrest of two people suspected of plotting an attack on rebels. Life sentences for the British couple who are planning a suicide attack in London to mark the 10th anniversary of the 7/7 bombings. One of the world's most famous is appearing in court to face sexual assault charges. Bill Cosby is accused of drugging, then sexually abusing a woman at his home near Philadelphia in 2004. After months of accusations, it's the first time he's been charged with any offence. His lawyers insist the charge is unjustified and that he will be cleared. He has been freed on bail of $1 million.
Oh.
This is from our Washington correspondent, Laura Beck.
$1 million.
He was once the most watched man on television. For decades, the funny family entertainer hailed as the honorary dad.
What are they doing?
Now he must face the cameras once again to hear details of the criminal charges against him. We involve Andrea Constant, who has waived her right to anonymity. She says she went to his house for career advice.
Mr. Cosby urged her to take pills that he provided to her and to drink wine, the effect of which rendered her unable to move or respond to his advances, and he committed aggravated indecent assault upon her.
There have been allegations and rumors for years, but new evidence has emerged. The charges today are based on a deposition from a civil case where Bill Cosby admits giving women drugs before a sexual encounter. He says it was consensual. Nearly 60 women have now come forward. Many of them spoke to New York Magazine, high-profile models, entertainers, and actors, all with similar stories.
His behavior was like that of a predatory. I woke up in the back of my car alone. My clothes were a mess. My bra was undone.
Legally, many of his accusers have run out of time to bring criminal charges.
For many of my 29 clients who allege that they are victims of Bill Cosby, seeing him criminally charged and having to face a trial is the best Christmas present that they have ever received.
He's always denied the allegations and is free on $1 million bail.
Stick.
If convicted, this once global star could face the last years of his life behind bars. Laura Bicker, BBC News, Washington.
University of Pennsylvania spoke to us earlier. She told Alice Baxter more about these particular accusations and why this case has been brought now.
Well, first of all, the accusations were brought because of the transcript that came out from when he had a deposition in the case of Andrea Constant. This was many years back. And basically, it outlined all of the things that Bill Cosby sort of said that he did, but that Andrea Constant was paid out. The other women who were in the suit did not get any funds whatsoever. And since then, because of all the uproar and the very poignant cover on the New York Magazine that happened, I think that this has put this in the public eye, and the re-release of the transcript of his statements before that trial made it impossible for people to ignore. And it's a different time also, I think.
And just reminding you as to how big a figure Bill Cosby is in America, particularly as a moral figure, who, like the head of a family.
Yes, he is iconic. In the 1980s, his show, you know, The Cosby Show, was watched by millions and millions of people. He was a father figure to many, including many African-Americans. And because of all the things that he did, the kind of philanthropy that he did, the kind of issues about respectability that he spoke about, you know, you should get an education, you need to pull your pants up, you need to start having babies, all of that kind of thing. He became sort of an iconic figure, in part because of not just the visual character he portrayed, but the kind of messages that he put out. So to have these kinds of accusations, I think, have been very troubling for a lot of people.
Yeah, sort of ultimate head of a family,
yeah,
wasn't he? Speaking of family, how have his own family reacted through all of this?
Well, this has been very interesting because what his wife did a few months ago, I thought, was very telling, in which she tried to besmirch the stories of the other women who were accusing him. And she has been his staunch supporter. Camille has been, her own right, a philanthropist, involved with many black universities in the Americas. I think that for the family, it must be very embarrassing because they were, like, before the Obamas, the first black family. And I think this is what has really troubled a lot of people. And for many, I think, it's very difficult to think of Bill Cosby with these, you know, alleged charges against him.
Professor Anthea Butler there talking to others earlier. In China, 8 miners have been found alive after being trapped for 5 days in a collapsed pit. Rescue teams in Shandong province have not yet been able to free them. They have managed to get supplies through. From Beijing, Stephen Evans.
Rescue workers bored a series of holes down into 2 areas deep underground where they think miners are trapped. A total of 17 miners were caught behind a massive rock fall, which was so severe that it was detected at China's earthquake monitoring center. After 5 days of relentless effort, infrared cameras detected signs of life. Boreholes were made and contact established.
Turn off.
Please be calm and wait patiently. We are sending you food soon. What are you saying? Everybody, be quiet. What do you need? Okay, miners' rights. They will send lights and food right now. Wait a second. Please drink some nutrition liquid first. Okay, we got it.
It emerged that at least 8 are still alive. Food and lights have been sent down. But conditions underground are treacherous. Rescuers are having to retreat in the face of further rock falls and sudden inrushes of water. The authorities are keen to be seen to be doing everything possible. There is sensitivity about the safety record of China's heavy industry. Chinese TV is playing pictures of officials at the scene directing operations. Parallel to the rescue, a criminal investigation is underway to see if negligence caused the emergency underground. Over the weekend, the mine owner jumped down a shaft to his death. Police said it was suicide. Stephen Evans, BBC News, Beijing.
I will let you know the first day. Of course, more of the main news for you. Switzerland's Justice Department disclosed about $80 million in bank accounts linked to the corruption scandal engulfing FIFA, the governing body of world football. Swiss officials have also handed over the first batch of evidence requested by American prosecutors investigating allegations of bribery for the right to screen big international tournaments. Counting has begun in the Central African Republic. Many thousands of people have cast their vote in long-delayed presidential and parliamentary elections. After years of sectarian violence, UN peacekeepers and police were deployed to prevent disturbances. The election was peaceful and there was a strong turnout. 30 candidates are vying to become president. Results expected in the next few days. Migrants and refugees have made their way across the Mediterranean to Europe in 2015, most fleeing the conflict in Syria. This huge migration has aroused compassion, horror, and much debate about how to resettle so many. But today is the last day in office for Antonio Guterres as UN High Commissioner for Refugees. He spoke to the BBC World Service.
For the first time in meaningful numbers, refugees and other migrants came to Europe, and Europe was totally unprepared for that. But not only it was unprepared then, it's still unprepared today, and it was unable to put itself together, and the divisions in Europe do not allow for a European response to this situation. So the refugees came to the developed world, and that made it an issue in the global public opinion, in the international community's priorities. That is probably the only positive thing about this tragedy. For the first time, political leaders all over the world took it seriously. The point is that we do not yet have a response to that. So it is clear that this problem could have been managed. But to be managed, it would be necessary to have all European countries assuming the common responsibility. First of all, doing their best to address the root causes, doing their best to contribute to the peace in Syria or of other crises. But at the same time, recognizing that many would come, preparing that arrival with adequate reception conditions at entry point. This would require an important investment. If proper reception conditions would be in place and a fair distribution of people to all European countries, this crisis would have been perfectly managed. What we are seeing is that countries are trying to solve the problem by themselves, trying basically to avoid refugees to come into their borders and to go into the neighbor's one. And some countries that are trying to have a regime that is a little bit worse than the neighbor's regime to make sure the refugees go into the neighbors and not to their own country. 86% of the world refugees are in the global south. And a fair share would be for the global north to also assume its responsibilities in a way, sharing these efforts. I believe that now, when we look at the present situation in Ukraine, in my opinion, either Europe is able to put together a massive admission program from the neighboring countries of Syria in the months to come to replace that tragedy in the Aegean and that chaotic movement in the Balkans, or if that is not put in